Snyder family. This is your lovely host, Miss Nadia Simone. And today we're kicking it with Van Johnson of Black Ink Crew. We're celebrating his birthday and the anniversary of his clothing brand, Chicagorilla. With the man of the hour, Mr. Van Johnson of Vh1 Black Ink, and his brand, his clothing brand, Chicagorilla. How are you?
I'm doing well, very well. Thank you for having me.
Of course. You have obtained this big, huge role as the boss of the 09 Mag Shop. How has that journey been?
It's actually been kind of crazy because I never really seen the separations of the shops. But when I was, you know what I'm saying, had to lead that lead role like that, it was like, okay, what do I do now? Because this shop is such a disarray. How do I take over? How do I invest all of my money from this business over into this business? So it's actually been kind of crazy. But seeing black businesses flourish and go to the next level, that's all I've ever wanted to see, whether good or bad, you know? So it's been a journey.
Awesome, awesome. So let's talk about your Chicagorilla brand. Now, you are the part owner of your Chicagorilla brand. How is entrepreneurship going for you? And just tell us more about your brand.
Entrepreneurship for me has been great because I never really like to actually work a real 9-to-5. Shout out to everybody that does, because that's an extreme role to take on and get up every morning and commit to something every single day. But me being an entrepreneur has been a very stressful and very extreme. But just to do it and take on something that I never thought that would actually work for me, just taking a leap of faith and just keeping God first, it's catapulted me into a whole nother level, whole nother tax bracket, and I love it. So I really acknowledge everybody that's out there trying to do it, and to actually keep it going, you have to be dedicated. You have to take some hits, you have to take some bumps, and you have to keep on grinding and keep on going.
Awesome. Now, Chicagorilla is a brand that represents loyalty, perseverance, and strength. So how do you apply that in your everyday life?
Life is every day. It's perseverance, it's strength, and it's knowledge. And it's also to know the ledge, which is knowledge. So to know the ledge, if you tip over that ledge, you know that there's nothing going to be over that ledge but death or something that may become shorter that can maybe cripple you. So knowing the ledge, I've always know the ledge and know the balance of my lifestyle, and to just stay right above it and do exactly what I need to do to not tip over that ledge. So I've become conscious enough to just keep my team straight, grind, and keep everybody in a steady flow. And I preach this to all of the teamwork and all of the people that work for me and work with me. And I just want to do great, and I want to inspire others to do exactly the same.
Awesome, awesome. So how do you balance, because you have a teenage daughter, right? How do you balance that, you know, being a boss, having your own business, your love life? How do you balance all of that?
Well, actually, my daughter's here right now. I want my daughter to stay around and see exactly what goes on, whether good or whether bad. And when she sees things that's going on, my daughter's very inquisitive. She want to know exactly what's happening, what's going on. A very spoiled little kid, but she's very, very smart. And she knows exactly when she's, you know, when you're a teenager, you see exactly what's going on. Ask questions. I have to be honest with my daughter nowadays, you know what I'm saying? So when she see me doing things that she don't agree with, she has a voice and has a reason behind why that she see her dad doing, you know what I'm saying, certain things that she don't agree with. So I have to also tell her that I'm an adult. This is the way that I do things, and if you disagree with it, let me make it right. But I show my daughter time and time again, this is how you do things on the right way. And if it's wrong, if you disagree with it, let me hurry up and make it right so you won't make those mistakes.
Awesome. Great example of a dad. Yes, I love it. And I love seeing you interact with her on the show. So what is next for you? You just opened up a new shop for yourself, the Cold as Ice Tattoos?
Yes, me and my business partner was fortunate enough to open up again Cold as Ice Tattoos. We had it in the past, but now in the future now, well, in the present, we open up Cold as Ice Tattoos again. And in the near future, we want to open up more franchise businesses for Cold as Ice to let young black entrepreneurs and artists get their way and get their artistry out there. And we can work under one umbrella, one roof, so everybody can actually get a sense of entrepreneurship, branch off and do their own thing.
Awesome, awesome. Any shout outs you want to do before we wrap it up?
Yes, shout out to yourself. Shout out to your company. Shout out to Cold as Ice, shout out to NIMAG. Shout out to VH1 for giving us this platform to be able to get all of these people in tune with what black artistry is and entrepreneurship is. And shout out to, of course, Chicagorilla. Everybody out there, y'all with Black and Crew Chicago, Van, and y'all watching theNSider right now. Y'all better get in tune, baby.
Yes, thank you so much, Van, and congrats on everything.